Hey everyone, it's Lisa. Happy Friday for real this time. It is Friday and we are getting ready to, let's see, it's 9:56 and we're getting ready to get out of here kind of early and, this morning. I then go do some stuff for the day. And one of the things that I was hoping to pick up yesterday, and of course, here's some jets going by. Every time I start video and all kinds of crazy noises happen, but anyway. Yesterday I was supposed to pick up my lip painting, the lip prints. I had the little one and the big one framed, and I also had something else kind of special framed, and they called me yesterday at 5:30. We were just getting ready to eat and said that I could pick them up at 6, and it's all the way across town, so I didn't get to go there yesterday. But what I'm going to do, hopefully, is show you the other few things that I got yesterday, and then add on later this afternoon, I'll show you pictures of, or show you the prints that I had framed. I'll probably be looking rough because it's humid today. Every day it's so humid. But anyway, and I have been using a new shampoo and conditioner, but I want to use it maybe 2 more times before I give you a review, the heads up, because I've used the last 3 times, and I've been using it different ways with different like products to style my hair, just seeing how it does. And it is a drugstore, so I'll give you a report on that soon. Okay, this is something that I just got yesterday. I was waiting for, I got it yesterday afternoon, and I love them. They are the Steve Madden, let's see what they're called here. Steve Madden Women's Jilly Dress Sandal, Blue Suede. And I read the reviews. I actually saw them first on Nordstrom. I was looking at dresses and stuff. And I saw these and I just love them. You know, I love like this style, kind of retro looking. I love blue. Of course, it's like the perfect shade. And I really like this style. A lot of them that I've seen have more of an ankle strap. And I've noticed that when you have that and then have a big heel and barely have anything on the toe, it's, I don't know, it makes, they're not as sturdy. These are put together more like my Michael Kors Annabelle platforms that I love and are very comfortable. And they got great reviews. I think they come in another color, maybe a more nude type color. But you know, I had to have the blue. And I hate I don't have them buckled so you can see. But I really was thinking they would look good with some of my like flowy dresses. I just thought they would be the perfect fall shoe. And another good thing about them not having an ankle strap that goes like this is I can wear them with jeans. Like if I wanted to wear them with skinny jeans, you know, maybe my mini flare or something like that. But I just think they're so pretty. And I think they were $99. And I'll spray them with my Ugg spray. But because they're dark, they'll probably be okay. So, that I'm excited about those. And my box, gosh, the whole Zappos box was just like destroyed. I don't know what's going on with my mail lately. And then another, let me put these up. Another thing that I got this week that I wanted to show you. I thought about it yesterday and I thought, I don't know if I'm going to keep that or not. But, because it was kind of one of those things. I saw Michelle Makeup MLC. I saw it was in her favorites. And I had looked at it before. And then I got it and I thought, God, why did I get that? I don't need any more eyeshadow. But this morning I thought, well, I'll go ahead and use that palette and then I can tell you guys, it wasn't very expensive. I can tell you guys what I think about it. And it is the new Lorac Pro Metal palette. And so I used it this morning and I will zoom in. So I used it and I do think it is a beautiful palette. I think the colors are gorgeous. She really loves this rose gold, and that is a beautiful color. What, of course, attracted me is the dark colors. I loved, like, this color and that onyx, the way it has, like, the duochrome in it. And so I used it today, but Fallout City, I mean, it, like all Lorac palettes, they all seem so, it's like they're not packed tight or something. As soon as you put your brush in them, they just kind of crumble. And I was trying to knock off my brush as much as I could, but then I wasn't getting the pigment that I wanted to. And I used a soft ochre paint pot by MAC. So anyway, I was trying to, first I usually just knock it off on my sink, on the faucet, and that way it gets on the sink and I can just rinse it down. And it was, so much was coming off, I decided to just try to blow on it a little bit. And anyway, after I did my makeup, I'm not one to do my eyes first. I just can't get into that. I don't know what it is. But so I did have a lot of like darkness that I had to wash away and kind of redo. And so though I like it, I don't know if it's one that I'm going to be going for. But if you were like her and you want to use most of the like rose gold and amber and those lighter colors, especially that gilded, that gold is really, really pretty. Let me hold it back here. And I think you would like it. I think it was like $26. But I am probably, Brooke's going to a sleepover with two girlfriends that they all three love hair and makeup. And I am probably going to give this to her to take with her and let them mess with and give to one of her friends, because I would rather just, I use dark shadows too much. I would probably just rather just use one that doesn't have as much fallout. So that's my opinion. I think it's a good palette. I think it's pretty colors. It just has too much fallout and dust for me. And I'm just kind of funny about that. I'm probably funnier than most people. And I have two big things to show you. And one is what I have on. I told you guys, I went in Oliver and they were getting all of their, let's see, let me tilt this down some. I'm going to see my laptop. But they're getting in all their fall stuff, and they got in this jacket. It's suede, and I'll show you in my outfit of the day, but it's suede. It's, the brand is Obey, which is the same brand as my jacket from last year. And I just noticed I got the small, and I thought I had gotten the medium. But I don't know, the small seems to fit. You have to let me know what you think. The small seems to fit my shoulders, and I won't be wearing it over anything big. And I did like, when I put it on today, I love that it's one that kind of, I love jackets that don't go all the way down, because then, you know, I don't know, it just feels like they're just so much easier. And anyway, it's the City Moto Suede, and this is the Oxblood, and they do have a really pretty hunter green. That's the first one I saw. I ran in there last week. I don't know if it was to get the lip print or something, but Kara had the green one on, and I was like, oh, and I didn't have time to really try it on or look at it, and it stayed on my mind, and so I knew I wanted this one. And it's oxblood, but I love that it's kind of like that purpley, eggplanty oxblood. It's, I really like it, and the price is good, I think, for a nice jacket. Anyway, it's $224. Looking at the wrong, I should have never done that video yesterday with this webcam, because now it's messing me up again. And I know the quality wasn't good, so I won't do that again. So please be nice. The only reason I even thought about using that is because when I keyed in, I'm having to kind of do things different now that I've updated my program. And when I keyed in webcam, that one came up. And I thought, huh, you know, I probably would have never thought about it. But anyway. So this is a City Moto Suede Oxblood, and it's $224, which I think is a phenomenal price for genuine leather. It says the Obey Leather Collection is made of genuine leather. Leather is a natural material and therefore will change in appearance as it is worn, loved over time, inherit of the natural beauty of leather, which is what I like. I like them to get worked in. And she is doing 20% off, and I just think this is the perfect transition piece for us into fall, and I can wear this all year round. It really doesn't get cold here until after Christmas. Usually February is our coldest month, January and February. And so it's going to be perfect. And the first thing I thought of is wearing it with a dress. But since I wore a dress yesterday, and I haven't worn skinny jeans in a long time, I'm wearing skinny jeans today. So I'll go ahead and do my outfit, and then I've got one more big thing to show you. So I'll be right back.
I just got on my frame. Lay skinny jeans. I haven't worn these in so long, and they are the ones with the rips and everything, but they're not quite as bad as like the 1 teaspoon. And then I've got on my Vince, this is one of my favorite t-shirts. It's the little boy tee that has the cap sleeves. I want to get the white one. They fit out of my size. I wear a medium in this. And then this is the small jacket. So you guys will have to let me know. I think I'm going to keep the small. I think it looks fine. I think it's probably where it's supposed to be. And I just think it's beautiful. I think it just looks like such an expensive jacket, and it's not for what it is. And it has plenty of room to zip. And I love like the little belt and stuff at the bottom. I just love it. I think it's so pretty. And then the shoes I have on, I wanted to put on something a little different, not just black. And so I've got on my Stuart Weitzman. These are the lead Nouveau pumps, and I love these. They've kind of got a little bit of iridescent, and they're very,
and the
very
next thing I want to show you is something very, very, very special. Further than money or value, it's sentimental value. And I just got this, and I hate to take it off because I can take it off. It's the bracelet that was so hard to get on. But anyway, I'll go ahead and show you this. This is like the Parker chain. This is the Parker chain bracelet. I asked Sheila if she would make me some of these because I just thought that would be the prettiest bracelet. I'd love some of the, I think next time she's going to make some Trevor ones too. But this is the Parker. And I'll go ahead and do my other accessories. I just wanted something quick. These are the first studs. I thought about the big rhinestones, but I just put in these little Lilu studs from Sheila Fajal, and they're silver. And nail polish is the same, the ones that I was telling you about yesterday. The nude, I love it. It's the Forever Fawn, I think is what it's called. The one I showed you yesterday, I just love it. And bar necklace, just because I never take it off. And but let me back up. Let's see. My mom, you know, loves looking at Craigslist, and she likes looking, well, she loves looking like at puppies and kittens and stuff like that, and she'll look for like different other things. My parents are just, they like stuff like that. They always go to different shows and stuff like that. And when I was doing my room, she was really helping me look for maybe like a big chair or a small love seat or something here to go in my room. And I said to her, I said, well, I'd love for you to look on there and see if you ever see any good Rolex watches. I'd love to buy, you know, a pre-owned Rolex watch, maybe that had been refurbished or something like that, because I could never, even if I had the money to spend, I just couldn't spend it right now. I just don't feel mentally prepared to spend that much money right now. And so I ended up going over there like a week later or so, and I was sitting on the couch, and my mom was right here, and my dad was over in his recliner. And I told my mom I had just seen Marissa Webb with a men's vintage Rolex. I think her husband had just given it to her. And I said, you know, Mom, I said, when you look at, I said, have you seen any Rolexes on Craigslist? And she said, no. She said, what style are you looking for? I said, well, you know, actually, I really think I'd rather have a man's Rolex. And my dad said, well, just take mine. And because he's got, I think, three or four of them, just different styles that he's bought over the years. And I said, no. He said, yeah, take mine. Take it. And he's already given my brother one. So he gave me the choice of two of them, and I chose this one. And it is the, it's a pretty, here, I'll take it off. This band is kind of complicated. I'm having to learn how to put it on. But this one is the Submariner, and it is, I guess, I looked up what is considered vintage in a watch, and I think they, some places said 30 years, and I cannot get it off. Some places say 30 years, and some places say, oh my goodness, 20 years. Oh my goodness, I can't get it off. I'll have to just show it to you guys like this. Upside down. But anyway, here you go. But anyway, it's a Submariner, and I love it. It's just the perfect size, everything. The kicker was, he gave it to me probably about 2 months ago. My dad's huge, and it was huge on me. I mean, it was like, I could have just taken it right off. So I took it to the Rolex dealer here in town to have them take the links out, and there just were not enough links to take out. And it had, over time, the links will kind of stretch out. So I ended up having it just, it cost, anybody knows, it cost a lot to work on them, and it cost a lot to have them refurbished. And it's almost like a brand new watch. It's a new dial, a new face, a new, band. It's been pressure tested. It's gone through, anybody that's done all this knows what you have to do to get it like certified and stuff again. But I thought about it and I thought, you know, I would rather spend the money on something that was my dad's, that really means something to me. I like the fact that it's vintage. I liked everything about it. So I went ahead and did that. And so I just got it back last week. And I showed it to you last week, but I left my blankety blank air conditioner on. And you could barely hear me. And I just didn't want everybody to fuss at me. And I wanted to give it the proper attention because it's a big deal to me. And I did go and order this week. Oh, sorry, I got a itch. I went and ordered this week the, I think they call it a winder, but what it is, it's something that you put the watch on at night and it rotates it and keeps it, because if you don't wear it every day, it will stop. It's one of those motion. So that should be coming. I couldn't believe they didn't have one. It was the Rolex dealer here in town. And they don't carry them, so I'm going to be wearing this. I have missed wearing a watch. I really have. And I love it, especially with certain outfits. And I've enjoyed wearing it already. I've got to set it again because I didn't wear it yesterday. And it's already, it's still moving. I guess because I'm wearing it, it's moving. But it lost some time. So I need to get it set again. But is the date right? Yep, it lost a whole day when I didn't wear it. So I'm going to be wearing this, and I think the year of the watch is 85 or 89. I can't remember what the guy that worked on it told me, but I think that kind of classifies as vintage. I'm not sure. I don't really care. It's the sentimental value and just the way it looks that I love so much. Maybe make a video tomorrow. I'll have to just see how it is, because once we head off throughout our day, who knows what will happen. So I hope you guys have a wonderful weekend, and I will hopefully see you soon. Bye-bye.